Hi Capricorn, I'm Anisha. You can write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com. You can also visit my website www.tarotbyanisha.com. And this is your monthly forecast for December 2015. We've already reached the end of the year, Capricornians, and what a ride 2015 has been. We're ending the year, or rather beginning the month, with a grand trine that is there in the three fiery signs, that is Aries, Leo and Sagittarius, and it's lighting up a part of your chart that is all about behind the scenes. It's about spirituality, it's about research work, and it also speaks about doing a lot of charity. Now Capricornians, there has been a lot of focus on the psyche. It's pretty much when this house gets activated, it's asking you to do the spring cleaning of the mind, things that are really resting behind, you know, not just subconsciously, but maybe over past childhood issues, adolescence issues, patterns that have been there, things that have, or they can be incidents, experiences that have not been so great, but they have been, they're still lying, sitting over there, and how it is that you manage with that. All of it will come to surface around this time. And because we have, there is a lot of activity around in this house, the opportunity for you to be in a space where you can give, where you can do something for other people is going to be working as a natural healing process, Capricorns, for a lot of you. Also, this house is a house of skeletons, and it can be that certain secrets that come out. Maybe there's something that you've been keeping quiet about for a long time and you've not wanted anyone to know about it, and it just comes up on the surface, and it's something that you'll have to manage or deal with. Maybe you've just been avoiding wanting to speak about or to deal with it for a while. This also speaks about, it's also a time wherein your addictions, you know, patterns that have been very hard to let go of, and this can literally have to do with alcoholism, it can do with any form of drug addiction as well. So if you have been battling with, you know, either if it's been a partner or even for yourself, or it could be that you're working in a de-addiction center, you're working in a prison, you know, you're helping people over there, it could mean that as well. It's just a time that there is going to be a lot of interaction over there, and also there's an opportunity for you to be taking an action or doing something about it, or to be seeking help, or to be addressing these things. It'll be far more easier perhaps to be accessing that help around this point of time. And with this, in this house, we have psychological issues that really fester over a period of time. And it's a time wherein that it can at times turn into, you know, either you're having a tough time sleeping, or it turns into a headache, or it can be a need to be expressing yourself about what it is that you really, you know, your innermost deep desires are. However, since this is a house of undoing as well, try not to sort of be your own enemy, Capricornians. Try, you know, don't be in that phase wherein that to spite you, I will cut my nose. Don't do that. And be on a, be in a space if, you know, there's too much of the past that's getting surfaced, deal with it. You know, sort it out once and for all. And that is how, since we're ending the year, we're closing the year with this, with the beginning of this, it indicates that there's a great opportunity for you to be doing that and to be sorting that stuff out. On the 12th of December, we have the gorgeous Venus, and she's going to be entering Scorpio in your house of friendships, groups of friends, and also long distance travel. Now, Venus, of course, we know is a goddess of love, beauty, sex, and also money. And she is going to be coming and taking the sting out of the intensity that a Scorpio gives. And it can be that during this time you will find that hanging around with groups of people or like-minded people is really a pleasure. It can also be that you could just be connecting with old friends, maybe groups of friends, maybe school, college reunions could be there, and you will just be feeling quite happy. It's just a very happy space. It can also be that you could be spending time with someone who shares a similar interest as you do. It could be a hobby club. It could also be something, a spiritual club or somewhere where, you know, that you go. It's also a time wherein that You may start dating somebody who's been a friend for a long time, Capricorn, is because there's a Venus and there's a focus on friends. It can be that you've been friends for the longest and you just realize that, oh, you like this person more than just a friend. And there's just a sense of having a feel-good thing about your future. You're going to be feeling quite positive and quite happy about it. On the December 12th itself, we have Mars that is there in your house of career and reputation. And Mars is opposing Uranus over here. And Mars is opposing Uranus in your house of home, in your house of Cancer. So Mars, again, is going to be, it's all about action, taking decisions, aggression, movement. And Mars in this house of your career, reputation, your work is going to be... It's going to be really pushing you ahead. It's going to be asking you to take what it is that you want. And you're not going to be sort of be shying off and, saying that, oh, I think I'll let it be, or I'll, approach it in a different way. It's a time wherein you're really going to be quite unapologetically ambitious, ruthlessly ambitious. And you're going to be going all ahead and you're going to be taking whatever it is that you desire. Also, don't shy away from fighting the spotlight too much, Capricornians. It's a time wherein that there seems to be some form of accolade that could be coming your way. There could be a recognition that is there of sorts at your work, and people could be admiring your work. People could be giving you due credit for the work, or a project that is happening. It's also a time wherein that there could be a need to be constantly be this confident and this strong person in the eyes of maybe where you work. Maybe it's required of you that you come across as the person who's really in charge or in control, and that is irrespective of how you could be feeling inside. But this is something that you're pretty much being asked to play the hero this month, Capricorn, is now, because this aspect is opposing Uranus, and Uranus is the wild boy. He's the teen planet of astrology, which is really unpredictable, and he's generally does not conform to anything. And that has been there in your house or your home. That's the house of Cancer. It's also it also rules your mother. So here it can be that some of you could be finding either there are too many renovations that have been happening at home that could just generally be driving you nuts. You could be busy chasing the carpenter, the renovator, or the interior person. And there seems to be just a sense of constant busyness that has been there in your at your home place physically. Some of you could be buying or selling a house, leasing it, and for some of you, you could just be finding your parents being very unpredictable. You could just be finding that one day your parents are saying, okay, they want to do this. The next day you'll find them, okay, they want to maybe sell their home and come and live with you. Or there just seems to be a lot of unpredictable behavior, or your parents could just be feeling quite restless as well around this time. And it also indicates a move, a literal physical move. Some of you could change your house, or some of you could also be working from home as well. You may just change that equation over here. We have a full moon on Christmas, and it's happening in your house of joint finances, taxes, inheritances, and even sexuality and intimacy. And full moons are normally far more emotional than a new moon is, because it's a culmination of something. It's closing off a project. It can be that you are being asked over here to release something, Capricornians. It can be that... It can be a relationship, it can be a partnership. Maybe something has been really bogging you down and you've been just thinking about it for the longest of time, but you require that transformation, Capricornians. You need to be understanding that need to change, or to bring about that change in your own life, so that you can move ahead. And most of us, unfortunately, we tend to hold on to things that are even unhealthy. And it's just like it just becomes a safety blanket. I mean, at times even misery has its own comfort. You get so used to being miserable at a certain place or in a certain relationship that, you'd rather be miserable than be alone. So this is really a time wherein that you are being asked whether a certain relationship or a partnership has done its due course, and whether you need to be now transforming, or whether you need to be changing it now and moving on to something better and something newer. This entire month, Capricorn is for you. A lot of focus is there on how it is that you have been perceiving yourself and your work, and how it is that the socially that you are being looked upon. And for a lot of Capricorns, it's very important that how it is that you get perceived outside from the outside world, how it is that people view you or your status in the world. But this month, really, you are being asked to dig more deeper and look at the things that really matter to you, and look at the things also which could have become unhealthy or could not be really working for you, and maybe you need to be changing them. It's been a pleasure speaking with you, Capricornians. I'll see you soon, and thank you so much for watching.